Hello friends, welcome back. In the last session, we saw the advantage of the microservices. So in this session, we will explain you, what are the all the microservices we are going to create. So we will be creating a limit service microservices first. Then we will creating the exchange services. Then we will creating a exchange calculation services. So you know, and thereafter we will see what are the all component can we have, and each and every component is runs on the unique ports. So before starting the code, we will have to define the ports. Okay, so you know, we will be creating the limit service which can have these three port. The limit service microservices will having the only one port, but if you are bringing the multiple instance of the limit service, the port can be increased. So this limit service we'll explain you more. We will first create the limit service. We'll have a maximum limit and the minimum limit kind of the enhancement that I will show you. Thereafter we'll create a Spring Cloud Config server which have a unique port. Then we'll create a currency exchange service. So it's exchange service is nothing. Suppose you want to convert USD to INR. So what is the exchange rate of that USD to INR that service will provide you? There we'll see currency conversion service. So suppose you are converging $100 to INR. So it will first take the exchange rate and it will calculate what will the value or total amount of that INR. Then we will discuss about the Eureka naming server, where you will register all the microservices that you are writing. Then create the Joule API gateway server. Then we look for the distributed tracing server. So we'll go one by one, and step by step we'll be taking the baby step to make you understand better. So these are the ports that we will have to remember. Make sure you are not assigning same port to other microservices, else you will surprise why your microservices are not executing properly. Okay. So in the microservices environment, like we'll be developing currency calculation service, we'll be developing currency exchange service, and then the limit service. And limit service can be deployed into dev environment, QA environment, stage environment, production environment. Same like currency exchange service can have four different environment. Currency calculation service can have all different environment. So you know, this cannot be the hard code. You will have to configure the properties file in a common place, like in a dev. If you are deploying the service into the dev, then this application should read the properties related to the dev environment. Okay, if you are deploying this application to QA, the application should read the property file for the QA, like the database details or the path details where the file will be put and all. Okay, so same like this. So we will have to develop in a such way, like at the runtime, based upon the environment, it will look for the specific environment related configuration. So see, the dev is running environment is having one instance, dev one. QA can have two instances running, two services running on the different instances. The stage is running on the stage one instance. Production can have the two instances. So these are the basically, you know, if the load is increasing, your microservices services should bring up the another instance of your the QA service or the production service. So depends on the load factor, your the instances should scale up or scale down. Okay, but if the QA is having the two instances running of that microservices, they should point to the same QA configuration service. So we'll see the configuration management. So we'll developing first the limit service, okay, then the currency exchange service. The limit service will have a minimum limit and the maximum limit. First we'll see, we'll do the hard code of the limit service, then we'll making a REST API to show on the browser what is the minimum limit and what is the maximum limit. Then we'll try to read the limit service minimum and maximum from the application properties. Thereafter we'll see the how the limit service will communicate to the Spring Cloud Config server. So Spring Cloud Config server will connect to Git, where the Git will contain the all the configuration of all the microservices. So currency exchange service, if the currency services is running and requesting for the configuration, then Spring Cloud Config server will fetch the details related to the currency exchange service. If the currency calculator service are asking the configuration related to the currency calculation, then the Spring Cloud Config server will retrieve those information from the Git repository and will send back the response to the respective microservices. So currency exchange service is what? It's a nothing. It will give you the exchange rate of the converted amount, like USD to INR, USD to another euro dollar. So suppose you know, if your currency exchange service is asking what is the exchange rate of USD to INR, then it will look for that configuration file and will look the request that are coming from which environment. It will look the request and it will provide the configuration as per the environment the requests are coming from the source. So we'll be first developing the limit service step by step, then we'll connect to the Spring Cloud Config servers, we'll be installing the Git repository, okay, and we'll configure the all the place configuration in the Git repository. We'll go step by step. If something confusion you are looks like, nothing to worry, we'll go step by step, okay, and then we'll see. And we'll using the Spring Boot. So probably this is our this basically is our last theoretical and conceptual session. After this we'll set up a limit service in a Spring Boot. We'll show you how you can configure the limit services, but before that we'll do the hard code. We'll go step by step. We'll first set up a limit service, then we'll show you how if you are putting the hard code, how this will read and redirect to the browser. Thereafter we'll configure the application property. Okay, so if you are going here and if you are typing Spring starter.spring.io. Sorry, start.spring.io. So this is the Spring initializer. From here we'll be setting up the Spring Boot limit service project. So we'll start the project from that limit service. So in this overall the microservices application, we will be using the version 2.3.4. So make sure all that microservices that you are writing, either limit service or exchange service or calculation service, all should have a same version. We will be using the Maven project to build the application. Okay, so we will be downloading this, you know, the dependency, will be add the dependency. We'll see in the next step how can we configure the limit service, and we'll download and import this project into the Eclipse. So you go step by step, nothing to worry about if you are not understanding much. So this is the last part of our all the theoretical concepts. We'll start writing the microservices. So thanks for watching this. Up till now, bye bye.